They were known as blue boxes. Designed by Binghamton, New York engineer Edwin Link in 1929, these were the first commercially available flight simulators. To build it, Link used his experience working for his family's piano and organ business.
If you notice that there's four bellows underneath the airplane that are on the octagon table, and they tilt the plane from left to right, forward to backward, to give you all the pitch and roll sequences of flying a real aircraft. It turns on two-player pianos, which the mechanism is, you can see, that actually is turning the plane.
The first customers were amusement parks, but then the Army Air Corps realized they needed a way to train airmail pilots to fly in poor conditions using only instruments.
He sold in 1940s approximately 10,000 of these to the military services, and anybody that flew a World War II American-built aircraft, whether it was a fighter or bomber, had to go through this prescribed procedure of training on the ground before they even set foot in a flying plane.
The flight trainer, now at the Milton J. Rubenstein Museum of Science and Technology in downtown Syracuse, was donated by Syracuse University's College of Engineering and Computer Science. Associate Dean Earl Kletzky oversaw its restoration.
The people from SU went down in 1987 to an Air Force base in Texas, brought it back in a basket case, and totally restored, repainted, repaired, rebuilt everything on here, and had it back 100% operational.
The original instructor station was also restored. An instructor could tell a trainee what course they should fly, and then a motorized claw would track it on a map.
On a map on the top of the desk would traverse the top of the map and leave a red line where his course was. So if he told him he wanted him to land a certain place, he could actually change his course and line up on that runway.
For Engineering Week 2018, Aerospace Engineering Senior Nicole Roslin and other current SU students helped kids experience what flight training was like in the 1930s and 40s.
Because it's so accessible and really anyone can like take a look at it and fly it and just learn more about, you know, aviation. You know, they get to turn the plane left and right and maybe pitch it nose down, nose up. Every time they go around, you just see this huge smile on their face.
We believe that this is the only Link trainer in the world that the children can fly. Most of them in museums are behind glass or not accessible to the public.
Link Hall at Syracuse University is named after Edwin Link. This is the current flight simulator on the second floor. SU's College of Engineering and Computer Science is one of only a handful of universities in the world to have a full motion flight simulator. Roslin has flown in both models and believes the Link trainer provided the basis for all modern flight instruction.
Both simulators essentially work the same way if you look at it. Just this one uses those bellows, and then the one in Link just works on electric motors. But it's essentially just the same type of technology, just a lot more advanced.
There are only believed to be 132 original surviving Link flight trainers in the world. And the Link trainer at the most in downtown Syracuse is available for the public to experience.